los terroristas.
It's a Russian push-up. Canucks get their second power play.
2 minutes tripping.
Hit a guy that's 2 or 3 inches shorter than you, the possibility exists that you're going to get your stick up.
See if the Canucks can stay on the power play longer than 6 seconds. Daniel Steen had to take a penalty.
To take 200 feet from your own net, a great opportunity for Vancouver's power play that has struggled.
Yes, the power play 0 for 13 over the last four games.
There first, and that's why Taylor Hall's sitting in the penalty box.
As the coaches will tell you, don't put the officials in. Friends are there to greet him. They made themselves known with Nashville in town just prior to Christmas, and the green guys are doing their thing again.
Somebody slashes at a puck that's in your pads, then the referee calls it?
Right in the foot area as Paluschai gets the call.
Okay, Vancouver's mysterious power play goes to work, still third in the league.
Still don't know what it symbolizes, but I like it.
The Sharks, Doug Wilson sees Douglas Murray take his seat. Best power play in the league in the regular season.
Tough too, guys, because that's a great defensive play by Kessler. On Thornton.
So a third power play for Vancouver. San Jose hasn't had one yet.
And the back referee made the call, Steve Cazard.
Or power play, rather. Been a pretty aggressive start for PK Subban in this game, hasn't it? And after Sedin a couple times, and now Kessler. If you're going to target anyone, those are the guys to do it.
That's pretty much PK's game. He's into it tonight, and he's involved in every aspect of it. They're just checking the clock here to make sure that they.
Tom Cowell with the announcement, and it's a double minor to Gregory Campbell.
$1 million score and win. If any Vancouver player scores 5 goals in tonight's game, Patricia Graham of White Rock could win $1 million.
Christopher Skeeg's in the penalty box. I would assume it's for roughing.
He'll get a real good look. He's going to get a big and a good audition.
Again, it's the top-ranked power play in the league.
Two bad penalties, Versteeg in the second, and that one there by Commissaire.
And if Vancouver scores on this power play, it might be game, set, and match.
And they know that. First power play of the game for the Canucks. They only needed one last game against Nashville. Canucks went 1 for 1, getting the insurance goal from Alex Edler.
For the Vancouver Canucks, they'll watch here early on. Try to get some traffic in front of Jonathan Quick. Instead, a power play here, which a real chance for the Vancouver Canucks to take this game over completely.
Better win the draw, though, doesn't it?
That could force the issue a little bit.
Yes.
People have been wondering what and when there would be a response to the key hit last year.
Right. So this is what we talked about. One of the keys, stay out of the penalty box. Do not let the number one power play in the NHL get unwound, because that's why they're the number one power play.
Making contact. See right there, he tries to get out of the way. The rule book reads the offensive player has to avoid.
And the fourth line for the Los Angeles Kings in the offensive zone, Jim, gets an interference call as Halpern goes into the goaltender. As that one went and flipped on.
Took a hard hit and got a penalty to go with it. Three of the four goals in this game have been scored with a man advantage. And Williams is off. And Vancouver will send the Sedins and Michael Sammons.
Westgarth goes off as LaPierre got clipped in the neutral zone.
It's Oscar Moeller.
Oh, is it nine? Sorry.
That's okay.
But I have time to tell you that tomorrow on Breakfast Television, it's April 1st. Will you be fooled by the BT crew? Breakfast Television weekdays, 6 to 9 a.m. on City TV HD 214.